Hey guys, I'm back with another video, and today is going to be an Advanced Warfare information video. I'm going to be covering some of the things in Advanced Warfare over the next couple of days, so expect more Call of Duty than Battlefield. That's why I did a Battlefield double upload in the past 2 days, so hopefully you guys enjoyed that. That won't be on my channel for a while, because I'll be talking about Advanced Warfare and everything in it. So today I'm going to be explaining the Pick 13 system and the supply drops and what's going on with that, because some people seem to not understand what's going on with the Pick 13 system. So basically the Pick 10 system was in Black Ops 2, which was a great system for your class. One attachment, one perk, wild cards, those all counted as 1 point towards your maximum limit, which was 10 points. So I enjoyed that system. I don't know about you guys, but this one is going to be a 13 system. It is inclusive with the kill streaks. The kill streaks count as a point, so you can remove them and add more perks, more attachments, more secondaries, more lethals, more tacticals. All that kind of stuff will be extra within your class. So let's say you only want to run UAV and UAV only. I'm not sure if the killstreaks stack in Advanced Warfare. They didn't in Black Ops 2, so you might have to keep pumping out those UAVs if you do constantly get them. But yeah, those things will be added into Advanced Warfare. So that's pretty much the Pick 10 systems, just to clear that up for you guys. If you guys have any questions about it, if I didn't cover anything you had questions about, just leave a comment in the comment section below, and I will gladly answer every one of your comments. Now, supply drops are something that personally I really enjoy, because I play Battlefield, and battle packs are pretty much what supply drops are. They are randomized supply drops that you gain from either getting a certain amount of XP, doing certain challenges, or just time played. So supply drops contain three classes of items. I believe one of them is customization for your personal character, kill streaks, or they're called reinforcements. They're kind of like free care packages or free stuff you get in game when you set it to that time in game. So let's say you don't usually get kill streaks, you can't get a care package for some reason, so you just call that one care package and you get a random kill streak. Personally, I find that kind of stupid, because it's rewarding bad players, and I don't like when bad players are rewarded. As you can see in the background there, I just got killed by Thermal VKS. That's what I'm also talking about. Thermal is like rewarding by players, that kind of stuff, but I'm not going to get too bad into that. And the third class is different versions of your weapon. So let's say you have a BAL-27, I think it's an assault rifle. So you can get different versions of that, different versions that will suit your playstyle. One maybe with higher fire rate, but lower accuracy and lower damage, maybe higher accuracy, lower fire rate, more damage. Kind of like that stuff. I really, really do like that idea. That's an awesome customization idea. There is over 350 weapon choices when you include in the different versions of each, which is amazing. I think that's a good idea. I think Sledgehammer Games really did improve with their selection of weapons and all that kind of stuff. Sorry if there's any noise in the background. That's just my family, because my headset picks up everything that goes on in the house. But yeah, I'm also going to be explaining the kill streaks and how you can customize them. And in this commentary, I'll be covering all that too. So kill streaks in this game are pretty awesome. They're score streaks, they're returning back from Black Ops 2, which I'm super happy about, because that was one of my favorite things about Black Ops 2, was the system of you get UAV assist that goes towards your kill streak. You get an assist that goes towards your kill streak. It's not just this crappy ass point stack system where you get one kill and it counts as one little tick on the bottom right in Ghost. I just don't like that. It's not my style. I like everything you do counts towards your kill streak and rewards you in every kill and every assist you get. So kill streaks in this game, they're customizable. Now, it might seem weird and not like Call of Duty customizing kill streak, but I think it's a good idea. Let's say you take the remote sentry gun, you can either give it explosive rounds, make it a grenade turret, like from Extinction or something like that, or you can add on a it's called ripoff, I think, where you can take off the gunner part and use it as like a death machine, which I find really cool. I don't know if that's going to be OP. I don't know. I haven't played the game yet, so I can't say, but I'll be bringing you guys day one coverage of the game. Actually, day zero, because I already pre-ordered it. So yeah, you can add it, and it doesn't count towards your points in your pick 13. It'll only count towards the amount of points you need to receive it. So let's say you want to add a module to it that'll add 200 plus points to it. So instead of being 600 points, it'll be 800 points to gain. So you need to get like 8 kills or a combination of different amount of points. So that's pretty much it for the kill streaks. And the last part about the kill streaks are the co-op kill streaks. Now, there's a thing called, I think, a Warbird, and that is a kill streak where you can hop in it, you got the explosive rounds, and then a teammate can look at it and then hold square or X, depending on what console, I don't know, a PC, I think it's E, and you can hop in the same kill streak with someone. I find that pretty cool, but I wish it was you could choose who goes in it, because I don't want me to get a kill streak and then my teammate that I want to get on there, like my friend, let's say one of my friends is in the game with me and I got a kill streak and I want him to hop in it with me. A random person can just look at it and hop right in it, even though I don't want them in it, but I wish it gave me an option to kick him out. That'd actually be pretty funny and cool, but I like the idea of co-op killstreaks. They could be overpowered, I don't know, but you could just stay inside a building if it's like an air killstreak. I don't know what other killstreaks there were that were co-op that were revealed at the multiplayer event. They obviously didn't show every killstreak because I think there was like 6 or 7 of them that were actually revealed, but I hope you guys enjoyed this commentary. Please leave a like, subscribe, and comment what you thought on today's video. Tell me what I should cover in tomorrow's video. I'd like to know what you guys want to see, and yeah, please support my channel, support me, motivate me to make more videos, and I'll see you guys tomorrow with more Call of Duty Advanced Warfare information, so subscribe for more of that. Peace.